Hi, in today's video, we are going to talk about valency. As you know, everything around us in this universe wants to get stable. Same is the case for atoms. Atoms also wants to get stable. So here, there are two states in which atoms are very, very stable. One state is called as duplet state and the other state is called as octet state. Now, what is this duplet and octet state? If there is one shell in an atom and in that shell, if there are two electrons, then that is the stable state called as duplet state. If there are two or more than two shells in an atom, and in the valence shell, if we have 8 electrons, then that state is called as octet state. Every element that is in the periodic table, they don't have 2 or 8 electrons in their outermost shell. What they need to do in order to attain this state? Of course, they need to lose or they need to gain some electrons. And by losing and gaining the electrons, bond is formed. By moving on, have a look at the definition. The combining capacity of an atom is known as its valency. Edward Franklin was the father of valency, or we can say combining power, as he rephrased it later on. Having said that, in other words, we can say the number of bonds that an atom can form as part of a compound is expressed by the valency of an element. How we can find out the valency of any element? We have lithium. Atomic number of lithium is 3. In the first shell, we have 2 electrons. In the second shell, we have 1 electron. We know if there are 2 shells, then in the outermost shell, there should be 8 electrons in order to get stable. So now this lithium needs 7 more electrons in order to get stable. Is any element going to give 7 more electrons to this lithium? Is it possible? No, not really. No element is going to donate its 7 electron to this lithium. So ultimately, this lithium will lose its 1 electron. After losing 1 electron, there will be no second shell. We were just left with the first shell. And in the first shell, there are already 2 electrons. And now this lithium is satisfying the duplet state and now this is stable. So in order to get stable, what this lithium did? Yes, this lithium loses 1 electron. So now what is the valency of lithium? Yes, the valency of lithium is 1. The next example is oxygen. The atomic number of oxygen is 8 and there are 6 electrons in the outermost shell of this oxygen. So what does that mean? This oxygen needs 2 more electrons in order to get stable. As we know, if there are 8 electrons in the second shell, it is stable. It has already 6 electrons. It needs 2 more electrons in order to get stable. Oxygen will take 2 more electrons, and after gaining 2 electrons in the valence shell, oxygen is done with completing its octet state, and now oxygen is a stable atom. So what is the valency of oxygen here? Yes, 2 is the valency of oxygen here. The next example is sodium. Here, the sodium has only 1 electron in the outermost shell as its atomic number is 11. Now, sodium needs 7 more electrons in order to complete its octet. Is it possible? No, this is not possible. Rather than taking 7 more electrons, sodium will prefer to lose this electron because after losing this electron, the second shell of sodium has already 8 electrons. Sodium is very, very stable with having 8 electrons in its valence shell now. So now, what is valency of sodium? Yes, 1 is the valency of sodium here. Now, what is the valency of neon here? Neon is a noble gas. Its atomic number is 10 and in the outermost shell, there are 8 electrons. It's already satisfying the octet rule and it means it's very, very stable. So now, what is the valency of neon here? 0, because it don't need to donate any electron in order to complete its octet. So that is why the valency of neon is 0 here. Why iron shows variable valency? Sometimes iron shows valency of +2 and sometimes iron shows valency of +3. Why this is so? Now the answer is very simple, because iron is a D block element or transition element in the periodic table. Transition element stores variable valencies. They shows variable valency because sometimes they lose the electron from valence shell or they lose the electrons from penultimate shell. Penultimate shell is the shell right after the valence shell. Sometimes these D block elements or transition elements lose the electrons ions from the valence shell or from the penultimate shell. And why they do so? As we know, everything in this universe wants to get stable. And this is why we are learning valency here. So same is the case for these transition elements. In order to get stable gas configuration or stable d-block configuration. So when this iron will lose these two electrons from the valence shell, it will show positive 2 valency. When this iron will lose 2 electrons from the valence shell and 1 electron from the penultimate shell, it will show positive 3 valence. So this is the reason why iron shows positive 2 and positive 3 valence. So by concluding over today's lecture, valency is the combining capacity of an element, the number of electrons an element give, take or share in order to get its stable state is called as valence. So yes, this is all about over today's lecture. If you like the video, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much.